We shall now go on to our third presentation by Dr. Kajri Gupta, and Dr. Avinash would be the discussant for this particular case. On to you, Dr. Kajri, and I would want the next speaker, Dr. Sri Vidya, to have a presentation loaded.
Good morning to everyone. My thesis is on multicolor confocal scanning laser ophthalmoscope imaging versus digital color fundus photography in posterior uveitis. So multicolor imaging uses confocal technology, which uses lasers instead of light and scans the retina point for point. Three different lasers are used, that is the infrared, green, and blue laser. Each of these lasers produce an image which combine together to form the multicolor image. This is not a photograph in the true sense, but rather it represents a photograph because it does not give true color, but gives pseudo color. Since the lasers penetrate tissue to different depths and highlight different structures, the infrared reflectance tells us about the outer retina and choroid, the green reflectance of retinal blood vessels and hemorrhages, and the blue reflectance tells us about the inner retina. Because it is based on confocal optics, it gives better contrast, higher resolution, narrow depth of focus, better filtration, and better penetration. Because of these advantages, it has been evaluated in a number of retinal pathologies. However, its utility in posterior uveitis remains to be seen. We evaluated a total of 69 eyes with both active and inactive disease. It was a prospective observational study with various diagnoses, and all the eyes underwent concurrent imaging on multicolor CSLO, Spectralis, Heidelberg Engineering, and digital color fundus photography on the VisuPac fundus camera. These were arranged randomly and presented to two UVIX specialists who were blinded to the clinical details and the diagnosis and who graded the images independently. The images were analyzed by each grader for the presence of vitreoretinal surface abnormalities, depth of the lesion, whether retinitis or choroiditis, presence of fluid and hemorrhage, inactive lesions, and disease activity. They were compared to the gold standard, which was a combination of clinical examination, OCT, angiography, and autofluorescence. With regard to depth of lesion, for identification of retinochoroiditis, multicolor with a sensitivity of 17% was inferior to color fundus photo with a sensitivity of 100%. As seen in the multicolor image on top, the active retinochoroiditis lesion appears green in color with higher contrast in comparison to the yellow lesion on the fundus photo. However, although it was much better defined, it was difficult to differentiate it between retinochoroiditis and choroiditis. With regard to choroiditis, MCI was inferior to CFP with sensitivity of 84.5% and a significant p-value. The choroiditis lesions were further analyzed by dividing them into active and inactive lesions, and we found that the overall sensitivity of MCI for detecting choroiditis was correlated better with the active disease. And so the low sensitivity was due to the active lesions. As seen in this example, the multicolor image shows a choroiditis lesion over the macula with ill-defined margins showing active choroiditis. However, when correlated with the clinical examination and fundus photo, it is clear that the MCI lesion has missed out the most active choroiditis lesions shown by the black arrows. These lesions were not seen on any other individual reflectance images either, and they correspond to the more active lesions, which was confirmed by autofluorescence. Similarly, a choroidal granuloma was missed on the multicolor image, which was clearly seen on the fundus photo. With regard to intraretinal fluid and hemorrhage, MCI was inferior to fundus photo for both. Of particular interest was the high false positivity rate of MCI in detecting intraretinal hemorrhage. This was due to RPE hyperpigmentation, which appeared dark red in color, pointed out by the arrows, and gave the appearance of hemorrhage. MCI was inferior to CFP in identification of disease activity with sensitivity of 57% compared to 100% with on fundus photo and a significant p-value. So the lesions of choroiditis and retinitis are typically identified based on their color margins and edges. Although there's a difference in the appearance on MCI due to pseudo color, and this leads to error in judgment. In conclusion, the technology of MCI is relatively new and there is limited experience and should not be applied as a standalone modality. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Those of the judges who have missed out a particular presentation, please write not judged against that column. and the rest you all could do. And I would look forward to Dr. Avinash's discussion.
Dr. Gupta, just for us to understand the story behind your study, fantastic study and results with integrity. Now, what made you do this or select this topic or the study question? Why did it all happen?
So multicolor imaging is coming up as a newer imaging modality. It has been utilized in a number of cases of ERM in particular, where it has been found to delineate the superficial retinal structures better than color fundus photography, and also in cases of central serous chorioretinopathy and ARMD. So we decided...
Just in terms of limiting the discussion itself for uveitis.
Yes, sir. So it had never been evaluated in uveitis itself. So we decided to see how the lesions appeared on the multicolor imaging, because it so appeared that a multicolor image of a patient with retinitis was circulated and nobody could find out the diagnosis. So that is what struck us to actually do this study.
Right. My second question is, if there is an opportunity, let me reframe this question. So when you start doing a study and then when you start writing the manuscript, there will be an opportunity for you to reflect and see that I could have done this a tweak little bit in this methodology. What occurred to you when you were writing the manuscript or your thesis? There's something which could have occurred to you. Maybe I could have done this differently.
So one thing was that we took a mixture of posterior uveitis. So our patients had multiple diagnoses, from VKH to retinitis, toxoplasma and choroiditis, everything. So one thing that could have been done is that we could have limited ourselves to one particular diagnosis in particular, like choroiditis, and then found out how the lesions appeared on that, so we could find a particular criteria for defining choroiditis on multicolor imaging.
Fantastic. Last question to you is, what would be translational in your study?
Sorry, sir?
What would be translational in your study?
The conclusion and the translational would be that the studies on multicolor are still very few, and they...
Those are generic. No, I'm talking about very translational. Translational is, it's call to action types.
That we should definitely be cautious in patients with active uveitis in using multicolor imaging, because many a times the lesions are not visualized at all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kajri, for being trying to be valiant and get through with it.